Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding right to intervene written by Vijay Prasad. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how the monster of imperialism is still existing. This editorial is also about how we need to introduce more democracy at the global level if we want to do away with imperialism and tacit colonialism. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we need to understand about the word imperialism. Now, imperialism, this word, the meaning attached to it, it has undergone a change as per the change in the circumstances. Now, in the circumstances that were prevalent in the 19th century and in the 21st century, the countries used to intervene, used to usurp the territory of other nations in order to acquire raw materials, in order to supplant their own personals, their own system of governance, in order to sustain the butchering, in order to sustain the mining of resources from those countries. But in the present context, like the circumstances has changed, it changed the circumstances, the meaning of imperialism has undergone a change. Now what change I am talking about? Now, in order to intervene in some other country, in order to intrude in some other country, in order to transgress into the sovereignty of the country, new type of tools are used. Now why the new tools are used? The new tools are used because the older tools, like the war, like the battles, they have been negated by the humanity. But what humanity has accepted now is the welfare of the individual, the welfare of human beings. Now, this tool is being used by United States of America in order to intervene and transgress in the sovereignty of the other countries. Now, United States of America, it has transgressed the sovereignty of the countries like Yugoslavia. It has intervened in Haiti. It has intervened in Yemen. It has intervened in Libya, it has intervened in Syria, it has intervened in Iraq, it has intervened in Afghanistan. So these are the n number of countries that I have named in which the United States of America has intervened. Now why it has intervened? It has intervened because its intervention is legitimized by the United Nations. Now this editorial, Mr. Vijay, he has talked about R2P. Now what is R2P? Now R2P actually allows a country to protect the citizens of another country if a particular country perceives or contemplates that the rights of the other country's citizens are not being protected. So in that situation, a country will take the responsibility on its own shoulders and it will intervene in other countries. Now the responsibility to protect R2P. Now this kind of responsibility is a new tool for intervention. Now in order to get a better idea about how the superior powers, how the ascending powers uses such kind of tools, we must also compare this editorial with India. Now how can we do that? We can do that by comparing how the Britishers, they were using such tools in order to interfere, in order to usurp Indian territory. Now in the 18th and 19th century, Britishers, they had used the excuses of existence of misrule in the Indian states. This was one of the tools, this was one of the excuses that was used by the British Britishers that the Indian states are not being ruled well. Because they are not being ruled well, they have the moral responsibility in order to institutionalize a good system of administration here. Now this was done by Mr. Clive, Lord Clive. This was done by William Bentinck. This was done by Warren Hastings. And certain tools like the subsidiary alliance. Lord Wellesley. Now Lord Wellesley came out with the subsidiary alliance. Now in subsidiary alliance, he was trying to protect the states by stationing their own army in the territory of the other. And by this way, they were actually weakening the other states. Now, this was one tool, subsidiary alliance, and another tool was doctrine of lapse. Now, such kind of tools, such kind of weapons, the ideological weapons, or you can call them as also philosophical weapons in diplomacy. Now, such kind of weapons, they have been in existence for quite a long time. And the kind of weapon that this USA is using, this is against the ethics. So you can also use this topic from your ethics paper point of view. A question can be asked, is it ethical on the point of United States of America to adopt a role of the protector of the humanity? Or what should be done in order to protect the people who are under the tyranny of the misrules of their rulers? So what needs to be done? So finally, we also require a solution to what United USA is doing. Now how can this thing be done away with? Because what United States of America is doing, this is actually putting in danger, this is actually imperiling the concept of sovereignty. Now this concept of sovereignty, this concept of state, this concept of nation, it has come with the Treaty of Westphalia. And this concept of state and sovereignty, this it has enriched over time. And colonialism, imperialism, pseudo-colonialism, pseudo-imperialism should not be having the right to endanger this concept of state, this concept of sovereignty. And for that to protect, for that to be protected, for that to be preserved, for that to be shielded, for that to be enveloped from ulterior motives, we need to strengthen international democratic governance system. We need to do away, we need to completely rejuvenate, we need to completely redesign United Nations. That's the only way out. And for that to happen, we need multiple polarity, multiple strong polarity, where the countries can match to the stature of United Nations. This might not be possible now, it might become possible after 10 years. This was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on IAS Civil Services Preparation. In order to get the information of the classes, please visit my website brainyias.com. This was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice night.